Yes, class 9, today we are going to start with the topic descriptive paragraph. Earlier we have done for charts. No, so this is a new topic for you. Actually, this is introduced only since the previous year in the syllabus of class 10. And now this year they have included in the syllabus of class 9. Okay, and in class 9, otherwise what we have to do in descriptive paragraphs, sometimes analytical paragraphs are there in which a graph, a pie chart or a line graph is given or a histogram is given, and you have to that we have done. Yes, example we have to do. Okay, but this time according to the new, you can say, version of the syllabus, so they have given only of a person. So in case of person, when you have to write down a descriptive paragraph for a person, what you have to write down in that? Okay, so in case of descriptive paragraph, first of all, naturally it is descriptive. It means that it is describing a person, right? It is describing a person. So what you have to make, on what points you will write down about the you will write about the description of a person, right? First of all, you will make some observations about the person, then make some notes about it. Okay, add certain, you can say the qualities of a person. Okay, what are there? And then ultimately, then you write it down. It means that a descriptive paragraph of a person, it is the complete display of the personality, habits, as well as the qualification of a person. And at the end, you will also give a comment at the end that on the whole, what kind of personality it is. Okay, so this is always to be included in descriptive paragraph. So write down please for descriptive paragraph. A descriptive paragraph is a paragraph. What is descriptive paragraph? It is a paragraph describes the complete personality of a person. Okay, so it means that what you will include, that you will completely explain about the personality of a person in that. Okay, so as it is me. Okay, so in descriptive paragraph, first of all, what you will do, you will make first of all certain observations, write down first of all, make certain observations. Okay, make certain observations, and then some, prepare some notes on the basis of those observations. Okay, first of all, make observations. Then, on the basis of these observations, you will make some notes. Then, because these observations are made by you, then you will organize these notes. And on the basis of these notes, what you will do, you will make a clear worded paragraph. Then make a clear worded or connected paragraph. Or connected paragraph. Okay. So on the basis of it, what you will do, you will make a clear worded or connected paragraph. Okay, I'm moving aside so that you can have a look over that. Right? And it is always written for a specific purpose. Right? So it is visible on that side also. So, after writing.
Good morning, ma'am.
Okay, so now let us start with the useful tips that has to be written. Okay, let us write down the useful tips that we have to write down. Useful tips for writing a descriptive paragraph. So what are the useful tips? First of all, make observations. This is the first main point. Okay. Use rich descriptive words to describe the person. Okay, you will use rich descriptive indicators, rich descriptive words in order to describe the personality of a person. For example, he is well maintained, a well figured personality. So these kind of indicators or these kind of, you can say, descriptive words you will use, right? So always, so what is the structure? Structure of paragraph. So in case of structure of paragraph, you know that how always whenever you write down a paragraph, what you will do, you always start with the topic sentence. Start with the topic sentence. So what is topic sentence? That you also know that what is topic sentence. A topic sentence or the opening sentence of a paragraph, it gives us an idea what is going to be written in this paragraph. Like it is an heading, okay, but it is not a heading, okay. It is like, it is one, like one or two sentences which are giving us an idea that what is to be written in this paragraph, okay. So then afterwards, coming up to the middle, here what you will do, you will give a detailed account, give a detailed account of the person, of the person, for example, behavior, for a person you can write down for height, personality. Okay, qualities. Okay, you will also all mention that. Okay, you will mention all these points. Okay, so what these details they used to. Okay, this is the structure of the paragraph actually. So what these details will give, these details will illustrate. Okay, it concretize means what your observations are. It these words or these sentences, which are they will act as supporting sentences, means whatever the topic sentences, these sentences will support these details and they will concretize your observations. What you have observed, you are now writing in the form of a language. Okay, so you will explain about the person. Then afterwards, you will write down a concluding sentence. Okay. Then afterwards, you will write down a concluding sentence. So, in concluding sentence, what you will write down? You will conclude. Okay. With the comment. Okay. Write down conclude with the comment. Or the overall view. With an overall view about the person. Okay, so you will conclude giving an overall view about the person. Right? So you will write down in this manner. So, but you also, whenever you write down a paragraph, you also should check that it should be interesting enough. Okay? It should be interesting. It should be using various kind of descriptive words so that it can appeal to the person. It should not be too long. Don't ever think that we will write down a long paragraph and we will get more marks. No. To the point, accurate things, to be included here. Okay, so for example, write down so that I can give you an example. So it is written. Okay, now let us start. Suppose, let me give you the simplest example of your father. Yes. Suppose you are given a question to write down a descriptive paragraph about your father. So first of all, you will write down my dad. Heading must be there. Okay, so the first of all, what we will have the topic sentence which will give an interesting start to the paragraph. For example, if you see a well-built man, okay, with groomed personality among the crowd, that would none other be than my father. Okay, this is the topic sentence. It means that it has completely explained what this paragraph is about. So then coming up to the qualities of the father. Okay, he is well educated and by profession a dash. Okay, you can write down any profession and accordingly you will give the qualities. Okay, he is a well managed man with high profile and moreover he is a hard worker. He is perfect in his profession, doing or sorting out every problem. I'm not taking any profession. This is the reason why I'm not, you can say, individualizing the characteristics. Okay, you can write down on your own. Just I'm giving you an idea. Okay, you will write down 5 to 6 qualities. Okay, then afterwards, he's a great helper. He's a great social worker too, helping the needy people out. I have learned number of qualities from my father. And at the end, concluding remark. Okay, 5-6 sentences which will act as supporting sentences to that of the topic sentence with details of your father. Then afterwards, coming up to the concluding one, okay, comment. I wish I would always be, or I would be like my dad to imbibe all the qualities of his personality. And I think that my father is the world's best father. So this kind of concluding remark, okay. So now suppose if I give you a question to write down on a beggar. This, so I have given an example that you will write down in this manner. Suppose a beggar, to write down the question, write a descriptive paragraph on a street beggar, right? Okay, so first of all, the heading will be, this I'm just giving you a chart just so that you can have an idea. Okay, so here you will start with the topic sentence. Okay, then supporting ideas. Okay, what you will include in supporting ideas? Outlook, how he looks, then qualities, then routine, you will also mention, okay, then behavior, you can also mention about behavior, right, and then afterwards you will give a concluding remark. Okay, concluding remark you will also give. Okay, so you will write down. So let us start. First of all, topic sentence. First of all, heading, a street beggar or a beggar. Okay, so what will be the topic sentence? Most of the times, in the well crowded places, one can often see a man in tattered clothes, wearing rags, and barefooted, walking on the hot roads or walking on the heated roads and asking for alms. Alms means coin, small amount of money. It is none other than a beggar. It is, one can often see a beggar moving in the streets and as well as on the roads. Okay, I often witness a beggar on the roadside. A beggar is one of the most pitiful character of our society. Okay, then outlook, he's without any essentialities of life. Okay, wearing tattered clothes, wearing, you can say, torn clothes, and sometimes not with appropriate clothes. Okay, it is displaying. Then what are the qualities? He is also, soft-hearted. I don't think so, beggars are soft-hearted. Honest person. How beggar can be an honest? If he would be an honest, he would never have begged. What I think is, then he would have self-respect. Okay, so a beggar is often seen asking for money from the other people, but he's never working. Okay, the beggar I have seen is a person who is asking for money. He is, you can say, suppose if he is a handicap, you can also mention. Okay, then ultimately he is not taking proper bath daily. Okay, you will also mention that. His hair not properly kept. Okay, mention about all these routine. Okay, daily the beggar is coming to our street or to the street or to the main road for begging, and he spends since 9 a.m. to till 9 p.m. sitting there at one spot, seeking the attention of the bypassers. Okay, and people who feel pity of him used to help him with small coins or with small amount of money. That was all his routine. Nothing else the beggar is doing. So afterwards, concluding remark, but this is the most pitiable figure or pitiful figure for me to see. But I think that these kind of beggars, they should be replaced with a healthy human being and by social work. Yes? Okay, better place for them to live, right? This is all for descriptive paragraph, and this paragraph you have to write down in your notebooks. No, note down the question, please. Write a descriptive paragraph on a beggar. It must be written in your fair notebooks. Okay. Right. So for the time being, as we have 10 to 12 minutes with us, so I'm also going to discuss with you, as this is the last period of the week, some grammar portion. Okay. So for determiners, we are going to start. So for determiners, we are having different type of determiners. Why they are called as determiners? It is because of the reason that they fix the meaning of a noun. For example, if I say I have a pen, it means you will come to know that I have one pen. There are few students in the class. It means students here is noun and I'm referring few students. It means I'm adding some more meaning to the noun. Okay, so these are called as determiners. Why they are called as determiners? Because they determine or they add to the meaning of noun. Right? Different type of determiners we have. Articles. Then, you remember? Numeral determiners. Quantifiers. Demonstrative and possessive determiners, right? And the next one are the possessive determiners. So let me take the example. First of all, articles. Now in case of articles, a, an, and the are called articles. In all of the three, a and an are called as the indefinite article, because if I speak, I have a pen, I'm not referring to a particular pen. But the is called as the definite determiner, okay, definite article. Okay, why? Because if I say I have the pen I have is lost, it means I'm talking about that particular pen which I was having and it is lost, right? Okay, so where A or N is used, A is used with which sounds? Consonant sounds, okay? and an is used with vowel sounds a e I o u are vowel sounds, and in English alphabet rest all other sounds they are consonant sounds. Okay, moreover they are used with single countable nouns, singular ones. Okay, with singular a means it also gives a sense of one. Okay, for example I have a pen. Okay, next example I'm going to give you. Suppose I say the milk cost 25 rupees a liter. It means here it is giving the sense of per also. Okay, right. For example, next afterwards you, in case of exclamatory sentences, what a beautiful scene it is. Okay, in case of exclamatory sentences also a is used, right? So where the is used, numerous uses of the. First of all, when we are referring to a complete class. For example, dog, the dog is a faithful animal. It means I'm talking about all the dogs, not a single dog. Okay, the camel is the ship of the desert. Here the camel is referring to all the camels. Okay, when it is also used with the proper noun. When proper noun is used as a common noun, how? See, for example, Kalidas is the Shakespeare of Hindi literature. So here Shakespeare is proper noun, but here it is used as a common noun. It means it is referring to complete class of the literary persons who are in the profession of writing. So with proper, it is also used with proper noun, which is going to be used as a common noun. Okay, then afterwards it is used with the superlative degrees. For example, he is the world's best hockey player. Okay, he is the world's best, or he is the best student in the class. He is the tallest in the class. Okay, with superlative degree, what we use the. Then with the name of mountain ranges, the Himalayas, the Mount Everest, we are using the. Then with the name of oceans, the Indian Ocean, the Pacific Ocean, the Atlantic Ocean. Then with the name of newspapers, the Tribune. Okay, right? Then afterwards, meals of the day, I have finished the lunch. Okay, then also the breakfast, it can be used. Then where, what else is the use of the monuments, the Taj Mahal, the Red Fort, rivers with the name of rivers, the Gangas with the name of holy books. Okay, the Quran, the Bible. Okay, then also with the cities, for example, which are made up of group of states. For example, the USA, the Russia, the US, the UAE, which are made up of different states or different constituent ones. Okay, then one more example was there in my mind, I forget that now. So it is used with these, right? Okay, the, there are number of uses of the. Okay, so next afterwards we are coming to numeral determiners. Now numeral determiners, what are numeral means? They give us a sense of number. You know they are of two types. Which are these two types? Cardinals and ordinals. And ordinals. So these are the definite ones. Now there are indefinite ones also. Cardinals, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. He's okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. There are 4 students in the class. There are 3 girls standing in the corridor. Okay. Ordinals gives us the order. First, second. Okay. He is the first one to arrive or to finish the race. He is the second one to score this position. Right. He is the third one. Okay. He stood third in the class. So these are ordinals. They give us the order. Okay. Next, afterwards, we are having indefinite. Indefinite ones means we don't get a definite sense of number. For example, few, a few, the few. Okay? A little is coming into quantity. Right? Some, many. There are some students. Okay? Several. Okay? Many. Few, a few, and the few. What is the difference between these? Few, a few, and the few. See, few means seen. For example, let me enter. Two students are waiting. I don't know since how long. Yes, few. For example, few means negligible amount. There are few students means negligible, hardly one and two. Okay, a few means some considerable amount. A few students are ready to submit the assignment. Means there are few students. Okay, means considerable amount. And the few means if you are there, but all these. Okay, for example, suppose if I say in class 2 to 3 students are there, and all these 2 to 3 are ready to attend the class. So I will say the few students present in the class are ready to attend the class. It means although small in number, but they all. This is the difference between few and the few. Few is always used in the negative sense. A few means little bit positive sense, some considerable amount. And the few means if less in number, then all. Right? Okay. So clear this. Then afterwards, we are having possessive determiners. For example, this is my pen, this is your book, this is his house. My, his, her, their, these are possessive determiners. But don't write down mine. Mine is not possessive determiner. It is possessive adjective. Okay? This is, okay? This book is mine. No, this is not determiner. Mine is adjective, possessive adjective. My, you, my, your, his, her, there is possessive. Then we are having of quantity. They are used with uncountable nouns, right? Quantity, they are showing us the quantity. For example, some can be used in both, right? Much, much, there is much work left to be done, right? Much has to be done in this regard. Okay, little, a little, and the little. The same meaning that is carried by few, a few, and the few. And what is the difference between few and little? Few is used with number, but little is used with quantity. A little means negligible amount in negative sense. For example, there is a little milk in the jug. Means negligible, that cannot be used for anything. And then there is a little milk in the jug, but tea can be made from it. Means some amount is there that can be used in positive sense. And the little milk in the jug was used in preparing the dish. Means whatever the little amount was there, it has been used in preparing the dish. Okay. And the next, for example, I say the little money I had is spent for purchasing the new house. Okay. Whatever the little money I had, everything has been used. Right? So, done. Then demonstrative, this, that, these, those are the examples of these. Okay, right? Determiners, this and these, it is used for nearby things. Those and that is used for far away things. Right? So, models we have done on that day. Okay. So some and any can also be used in case of quantifiers. Some, there is some milk. Okay, both can be used. Any is always used with negative thought. Okay, with negative, where we are expecting negative answer. Do you have any pen? Means when we are expecting the answer in no. Okay, so this is all for determiners. And what you have to do, you have to solve the exercises of grammar. Okay, you are having your test on Saturday. So test was announced already. In the group I have sent already. Kindly check on Saturday's messages. On Saturday I have posted, right? So any doubt to any student now in descriptive paragraph? Especially if there is a mention of this descriptive paragraph, it will carry 5 marks. Okay, so you don't have to write long. Okay, one more short story is also there. We haven't done story. In the next week, we will do short story. But you are, in the previous term, okay, then we will have it. Okay, we will have it for 5 marks. Then I'll give you one story to write in the notebook. Okay, so that's all for today. The few means, although less in number, but that all. Okay, for example, give any, Yes, we are considering the whole. Okay. Yes. Let me take the attendance now. So that's all for today. Thank you very much.